Now guys, let us say I'm investing like this. Observe carefully. So I have a timeline. This is timeline time 0, this is time 1, time 2, time 3. Let us say I deposit 100 here, and then I deposit one more 100 here, and then I deposit one more 100 here. Let us say discount rate is 10% per annum. Can you tell me how much money will we have at the end of year 3? I have deposited 100, 100, 100 3 times, and I am investing that at what rate? 10% per annum. I want you to find out how much money will we have at the end of year 3. Alright, so how will we do it? Look at this. This 100 that you invested at rate of 10% here, by the end of the year it will become how much? 100 and? If you invested 100 here at the rate of 10%, by the end of the year it would be how much? 100 itself, because you invested just today. Are you following this? So if you just invest today, there is no interest to be earned. So this 100 is going to remain 100. Guys, this 100 we've invested for how many years? 1 year, this year, from year 2 to year 3. So 100 at the rate of 10% will be how much? 110. And this 100 we've invested for how many years? 2 years. How do we know that? From year 1 to year 2 and year 2 to year 3. So 100 will become 110, correct me if I go wrong, and 110 will become 120. 20 or 21? 21. Because next year we will get interest on interest, which we call as compounding. So 100 will be 110, and then 110, 10% we will get 11, it will become 121. Then add up the three numbers. What is this? 331. Okay. Now, what stream of cash flows that we have here in finance? What we call this stream of cash flow, we give it a fancy name, we call this as an annuity. Okay, it seems like a fancy word, but very simple concept. What it means is that we have a constant payment. A constant payment, and we have a constant interval. Okay, so what is the constant payment? 100, 100, 100. What is the constant interval? 1 year, 1 year, 1 year. The interval between two periods. And whenever you're dealing with annuity, you can make use of the payment button of your calculator. So instead of doing this manually, we could have directly done this in the payment function. Let's do it together. Do this with me. Second clear TVM. Second clear TVM. Now have 100 on your screen. Have 100 on your screen and press the payment button. Then have 3 on your screen. Then press N. Have 3 on the screen, press N. Have 10 on your screen, press IY. Then press compute future value. Compute future value, and you directly get the answer as 331. Are you okay? Will you be able to use this? Okay. Now next scenario. May I clear off the screen? Next scenario, observe carefully. Let us say I am making investments now in the similar fashion. Observe carefully. This is 0, this is time 1, this is time 2, this is time 3. This time I am investing 100 here, 100 here, 100 here, nothing here. And now we want to find out what is the future value. We are going to use the same logic. Observe carefully. This 100, guys, we have invested for how many years? 1 year, so it should become how much? 110. This 100 we've invested for how many years? 2 years, so it should be 121. And this 100 we've invested for how many years? 3 years. So we will earn 10% on 121, correct? So how much would that be? 133.1. Can someone please add it up for me? How much? 1 36.364.1. Whereas what was the total here? 331. Now in the second scenario, you're getting more money. Why? Because we are investing early. So if you invest early, you get more interest. In both the cases, we've invested 300, 100, 100, 100. But here you're investing early, you're earning more money. Correct? Now what if you are required to do this on the calculator? Let's use the traditional way. Second, clear TVM, 100 payment, 3N, 10 IY, compute future value. Oops. Second, clear TVM, 100 payment, 3N, 10 IY, compute future value. Is this the answer? Is this the answer? No. Because by default, your calculator thought that you are making this stream of payments, not this one. Okay. So this stream of payment is referred to as a end annuity. End annuity assumption is you are making payment at the end of the year. But this stream of payment that we have here, this stream of payment, this is referred to as a beginning annuity. And beginning annuity assumption is we are making payment at the beginning of the year. So what we can do is we can change the assumption of the calculator. Be alert here. We can change the assumption of the calculator. This is how we are going to do it. Do this with me. Press second, press beginning. Second and beginning. Second and beginning. The green dots on my calculator. Now it is showing you end. That means it is telling you that current calculator is on the end setting. Now press second and press set. Second and set. What do you have? BGN. So now your calculator has shifted to the beginning mode. Now press second and press quit. So you're outside the settings. Okay. So do you see a small BGN at the top of your screen? Yes. So that BGN here on the top of your screen is telling you that now your calculator is at the beginning mode. Okay. Now we can do this calculation directly. Let's do it. Second, clear TVM. 100 is your payment. 3 is your N. 10 is your IY. Compute future value. And it will give you 364.1. Are we okay with this? So if you're dealing with end annuity, your calculator remains on the default settings. But if you're dealing with beginning annuity, then you'll have to change the assumption of your calculator. Now, this beginning switch is a little risky because imagine you're solving some question on the exam, you move to beginning mode. You get that answer right. And then you forget to switch it back to the end mode. Then the entire rest of the paper, you're going to solve assuming that payments are made at the beginning and your answers are going to be wrong. And very high probability that the wrong answers you get are going to be one of the three options on the exam or one of the four options. Therefore, if you ever switch to beginning mode, then the first thing you do is after you've done your calculation, you switch back to end mode. So let's do it together. Second beginning, second set. Second beginning, second set. Oops, I'm getting it wrong. Second beginning, second set, second quit. Same buttons. Second beginning, second set, second quit.